Right. Let's get into this. I was unboxing a e-bike earlier and got a ton of tape on my knife, which was kind of dumb, but it's not been acting itself since then. I need to clean it off really good. So here's the device. My editor, Ben, hey Ben, is sending me other videos, which he is editing. And that is the joy of having an editor. Ben's awesome. Thank you, Ben. Cool. So we're met immediately with the device itself. Frontier X2, a little pull tab. Let's put the device here to the side. Fourth Frontier, quick start guide. There's obviously an app that this connects to show you all of the data. Get started, pair with the phone, wear the device, start recording, view the results. A little bit more information on the back there. I'm assuming this is the user's guide or the app. Let's see. Comes with a nice braided cable. Ooh, interesting. It looks like a proprietary charger, which is an interesting move. It's an interesting braided cable. And then there's what your charger looks like. We'll check that out in that connectivity in a second. Here is the strap that you wear around your chest. Nice and elastic. Looks like it holds the actual device on with some snaps. So that should be easy to take on and off. Yeah, I'm actually interested to know if you actually wear it this way. It looks like this strap might actually have some tech in it as well to accurately, like these look like sensors here. We'll have to check that out in just a second. Measure what matters. I think that's just sort of the bottom plate down there. Doesn't actually do anything. Cool. So we'll set the box aside. Here's the actual device. Let's see if I can't grab it. Oh, I'm accidentally turning it on by grabbing it. Or doing something. Ugh, kinda hard to get out of there. That's strange. Oh, here we go. Monitor your heart health in detail, seamless integration with your fitness ecosystem. Easy to download PDF versions of your ECG data. Big thing with devices like this that are more specific to a certain type of monitoring is you can actually share this kind of data with your doctor, your provider. 24/7 customer support team and relationship managers. That's nice. It's always nice to have good customer support when trying any new product in case things go wrong or you can't figure something out. So it looks like the charge port here kind of sticks out the side, and I'm guessing this just kind of magnetically aligns. Yep. So I think, yeah, what I'm actually seeing here is the device, it looks like, actually connects to the strap like that. And then I do think that the sensors are actually here, which is interesting. I think online when you're looking at the product, you see this and you just assume that these little nodes here are what actually senses, but I think it's the strap piece itself, which is super interesting. Let's see if I just... It's giving me a red dot here, which I'm assuming probably means that it needs to be charged. But in terms of build quality, I mean, this is metal here. This looks like a kind of hard plastic. Not much to it. This button, there's just one button to access every different mode and things like that. It'll show you a little bit of data on this tiny little screen here, but most of your data is actually going to be found on the app itself. That does it for the hardware. I guess we can look at the software now. So I have downloaded Fourth Frontier from the App Store. I'm gonna go ahead and say sign up and type in all this data really quick. All right, I'm gonna agree to the terms of use. I will allow location permissions, allow while using the app. What's my goal? Choose the most important thing for you right now. I think definitely explore advanced health technology. I think my biggest thing is just improve my health and fitness, just overall. I will allow it to grab all the data from Apple Health. I am a male, that's my birthday. Let's do miles. I'm actually like 6'1". I weigh way more than that, which is why I am interested in my overall fitness and health. I'd say I'm around 210 right now. I don't really know max heart rate in resting. I'm just gonna leave it there. I hope that it pulled that from Apple Health and it actually knows that. Hooray, you have successfully created your account. Send a verification link. Cool. All right, we'll go ahead and log in here. So, okay. Click here to look at your ECG and upload your data to the cloud. Click here to connect your Frontier X. Click here to set your alerts and start an activity. Let's go ahead and connect. I'll say okay. Connect. Searching for devices. Please press the red button. This little blue light comes on the proprietary charger, which I actually thought was pretty cool. Charging at 85%. All right. Connect. So it did find it. We're going to connect to the device. Connected. Great. Awesome. Looks like it's synced. Haven't really done much, so we'll go ahead and update the firmware. Let that do its thing. Please keep your device near the phone while the firmware update is in progress. Adjustable strap. I'm not sure how adjustable, how wide it can technically go. I know this won't fit me, that's for sure. All right, 100% on the update. Update successfully. Updated successfully. Need help getting started? Help. All right, that's kind of cool. Little FAQ help section of the website. Training load. Again, I haven't done anything yet, so interesting. You can add health tag, a health event tag, palpitations, and acid reflux. I wonder if it's gonna, is this gonna be able to know that? I don't know. History. Again, haven't done anything. Activity. You can pick from run, cycle, walk, indoor, strength, aerobics, box, hike, row, ski, sleep. Sleep? As an activity. Sport, swim, triathlon, yoga, rest. I'm gonna try a triathlon one day. Probably not. All right, it's got the time, 2:31. Oh. I guess I started an activity. All right, cool. So when you double tap, I'm learning and I should probably read the manual. When you double click, starts an activity, double click again, turns off the activity. Loud vibration, that's kind of crazy. Recording started. I wonder what happens if I just tap the button. Anything? Nothing. All right, so everything's pretty much here. Of course it's not on me, it's not picking anything up. That's wild. Cool, well, that kind of does it for the unboxing and setup. Obviously there's not much data here. And we're fully connected. I will probably actually, you know, take this thing around for a couple weeks and run around with it, have it track me throughout an entire day, see kind of what my body's up to and test out battery life and all that kind of stuff. And I will get back to you all when I am done with that. So let's talk about the Frontier X2 from Fourth Frontier. I've been using it for a couple of weeks now and there's some things I want to talk about. First of all, it's not the most comfortable thing to get used to just because it's like wearing a looser belt around your midsection under your clothes. But quickly, like once you put it on, you start running, you kind of forget it's there. And I found over the 2 weeks I've used it, I came to expect that feeling. So I'd say it's just about as awkward as getting used to wearing a watch if you've never worn one before, or wearing a new ring on your finger. It's a little weird at first, but you get used to it. The other thing is, I personally wouldn't wear this like 24/7. I put it on before a run. It's super easy to put on. I'll show you. I just grab both ends of, and I would do this under my shirt usually. Grab both ends, slide it on. They say it's okay to like put some water underneath it, the sensor parts here. So that gets kind of just stuck on me right there. And I've honestly found that the sensors pick up better when I do that. It just puts it in better contact with your skin. Again, don't wear it over your clothes. It goes on your skin, under your shirt. So I think they even told me like, don't put this on over your clothes, but just for terms of showing you the ease of putting it on, don't put it on over your clothes, it goes under your clothes. But the big thing that sets this device apart from a smartwatch, for instance, is the continuous ECG monitoring. So, you know, Fourth Frontier says this is the world's first smart heart monitor, right? So like watches are, you know, health tracking, notifications. I mean, these new Apple Watches do have ECG on them, but the difference here is for me to do an ECG like check-in basically on the Apple Watch, I have to go like this, I have to sit still, breathe calmly, and wait for 30 seconds or something, I think it is. So it's not a continuous monitoring and I have to like stop everything I'm doing to do this. This device is just always on, it's always running, and you are able to actually wear it for an entire day with a continuous ECG tracking. So in terms of like being an athlete, a runner, someone who cycles, right? Like this is huge because while you're working out the entire time, you've got not only like heart rate monitoring and stuff like that, it's got a vibration in here, it'll alert you of certain things, but also you have that continuous ECG monitoring. You can also broadcast your results anywhere in the world. So you can share it with a doctor via a telehealth visit while you're on call with them. You can broadcast to them. You can download your PDFs. There's tons of stuff you can do in this tiny device in terms of heart health and heart monitoring. So they actually have a little checklist here on their site which shows the difference between this and heart rate monitors or smartwatches. And really the only thing heart rate monitors, smartwatches, and Frontier X2 have in common, all of them, is heart rate variability, your HRV reading. So smartwatches can also do your breathing rate. They can do remote sharing of metrics, right? You can share results to your doctor from your Apple Watch. But the things that this can do that a heart rate monitor and, or other heart rate monitors, I guess, in an Apple Watch, for instance, can't do are continuous 24-hour ECG, ECG during exercise, PDF version of that ECG data, live streaming that ECG data, real-time vibration alerts, strain, and training load. So you can set a parameter here with your different windows of activity while you're working out. So if you want to stay within a certain level of activity, you can set parameters. So if you drop below, it'll buzz a certain way. If you go above, it'll buzz a certain way. So you can stay in that perfect little training area. I know with HIIT workouts, stuff like that, a lot of times you're trying to stay in a certain state of activity and heart rate and body movement, right? So this can help you do that, all without having to look at the device. You can just feel it. And I'll say that the vibration features in this device are actually really nice. Basically, that's what's setting this apart in the market. I'll also say that this is HSA and FSA eligible with TrueMed, it says. So if you do have one of those accounts, it's possible this can be paid for through that, or maybe a small amount of the cost could be paid through that. I'm not sure how yours works per se. So I personally have enjoyed using it. I think it shows some pretty interesting data. I sent that data over to my doctor friend, Jonathan Barrett, and he was able to look at it and be like, hey, you know, this thing is, it's fine. It's a nice thing. I think there's a very sort of niche market for it. And there's kind of two different niches, I think. So for one, you know, athletes who are very serious about training and conditioning and knowing how their heart health is and how, you know, what they're consuming and eating and how that affects things, much like with the Ultra Human M1 glucose monitor, if you need to be very aware of your body in that way, I think this thing makes a lot of sense. It shows very detailed information on how your heart is doing. I could also see someone who has a past history of heart disease, heart problems within their family, needing someone, or someone who currently has issues with their heart, AFib, whatever it might be, wearing this for extended periods of time to check in with your doctor, especially if you are constantly working with your doctor on this kind of stuff. This could be a great way of working with them and sharing your data with them. So those are the two sort of audiences I think this thing is really pushed towards and that make the most sense to me. As far as the design, I think it's built well. I like the way you charge it. It might be an interesting solution because of how small the device itself is. I've only charged it once and I've been using it every day and I think it's around 80% battery. Now, I've only been going on 5-minute runs. I talk about this a little bit on my other channel where I'm just trying to start the running habit. Don't like laugh at me. I'm just trying to start the habit of running. I've run longer distances for a longer time in the past, but I'm trying to make a habit that sticks. So I'm running short distances. Been wearing this every day for about 2 weeks now on my runs and 80% battery. So the battery is great. I'll say the form factor is nice. It's built well. There's really only like kind of two pieces here. There's one button and a very small screen that displays information. The only design change that I would maybe change is you're supposed to put the button facing down when you're wearing it. And when I turn it on, you probably won't be able to see this, but the screen, you should be able to read it, right? It's right side up in that way. But the problem is, I mean, I guess if a doctor is looking at this or someone, that makes a lot of sense. But for me, running, looking down at this, it's upside down. And I don't think that is the right choice for that. I feel like you could always take it off and hand it to a doctor or something. But I think they should flip the screen. Maybe there's a way of doing that I'm not aware of. But, and I honestly don't even know that a screen is technically necessary because you do have to pair it with the app to use it. And usually I have my phone near me while I'm using this. So it can store data. So if you go on a run without your phone and come back, that's a thing you can do, I believe. But I just don't know that the screen is necessary. But maybe it's for those people who don't take their phones with them and they want to look down and see the data right there as they're going. I guess that makes sense. That's probably why they did it. But hey, flip the screen upside down, so when you look down, you can see the information better. Last thing I'll note, it's compatible with Garmin, Zwift, Peloton, and others via Bluetooth LE, so you can connect this to some of your apps that you use for working out already, which is nice. I'm interested to see how Fourth Frontier continues to create products and what they come out with next, and maybe what the Frontier X3 looks like whenever that comes out. So yeah, if you're interested, 25% off in the description down below. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, please consider subscribing. Here on the channel, we talk about tech from an intentional living perspective. If that sounds cool to you, please consider subscribing. Like this video if you enjoyed. Watch this video next. I think you're going to love it, and I will see you in the next video.